Welcome in your science class. In today's class, children, we are going to discuss a very important agricultural practice that is undertaken by any farmer. Okay, and this is one of the very important aspect of agriculture, one of the very important tasks of any farmer. Okay, that is storage, storing of crops. Okay, children, India is a very huge country. We all need food continuously. We all need rice, chapati, dal, pulses, grain, seeds, oil, everything. That all is grown by some farmer. We all need it continuously throughout the year, but we all are not growing it. Not each one of us are farmers. Okay? So in that case, it is the duty of farmer to store the grains very efficiently and very properly so that everyone can enjoy it, everyone can have it. Okay, so storage means that when once the harvested crop, once we have harvested the crop, we have to properly store it. We have to prevent it from insects, rodents, rain. Okay, because there are few crops which are grown in specific crops, in specific season. For example, wheat is grown in winter season only. Rice, which is grown in rainy season. Okay, but we need them all throughout the year. So storing is very important. Storing is a very important task. Okay. Now, harvested crop should be safe from moisture. We have to prevent the crop from moisture. We have to prevent it from insects, rats, microorganisms, rain. So these all are the factors which sometimes affect our crop. So we have to store the crop properly so that we can keep them safe from these aspects, these harmful elements. So let us discuss these harmful elements one by one. Now the first of all is moisture. Okay, now children, once the crop is harvested, so the freshly harvested crop has large quantity of moisture in it. Okay, so that moisture can attract the growth of fungi and other bacteria, so that this all the crop can be damaged by these fungi. Okay, so we need to store any crop after drying it in the sun so that we can reduce the moisture. Okay, especially the freshly harvested crop, we need to dry in sun for some days, then we can store it, because moisture can also badly affect the crops, because it can invite the other fungi and bacteria. Okay, and they can affect our crop. Now the next one is insects. Now children, there are many small insects, many bacteria which can harm the crop. They can eat up the seed, they can eat up the grain. Thus that grain will be of bad quality, which cannot be germinated further, which cannot be used properly. So there are special chemical treatments. Okay, we do some special type of treatments when we store the crops in any garage or any granary. So we have to do this special type of chemical treatments. Sometimes in villages, people also use neem leaves. Okay, they also put the neem leaves in any sack or any granary where they are storing the crop. So they also use neem leaves to keep all these insects and rodents away. Now the another very harmful element which badly and on a large scale affects the crop is rats. Okay, you must have seen rats doing a lot of menace at your home. Yes, have you seen that? So these rats also affect the crops. So in that case, we need to store the crop or production in metallic bins. Okay, because these rats cannot harm when we keep the crop in a metallic bins. So we can, if we have to store large amount of grains, so we can store them in silos. Silos are like these metallic bins, long, very big and huge metallic containers. Okay, so silos are huge metallic containers in which we store our crops. So these are silos. Okay, so we can prevent our crop from rats by storing them in silos or in any metallic cans. Now the another one is microorganisms. Okay, microorganism, like small organism. Micro means very small, organism means living beings. So there are many small living beings that cannot be seen with naked eyes. Okay, we cannot see them with naked eyes. Okay, but they actually do a lot of harm to the crops. So we have to avoid from moisture and use specific chemical treatments to get rid of these microorganisms. I hope children you have understood what is the importance of storage. You have understood what are the various harmful effects, okay, harmful elements that affect any crop. I hope this lecture is clear to you. We have completed this chapter. In the next video, I will take a revision class to see how much you have studied and how much you have understood so far. This much for today, children. Thank you.